All right, coming up right after this game at the Hump, Kevin Purrier will take his 13 points a game and 5 boards and see if Kim Anderson's crew can get a win in Mizzou. But now back to Matt and Mark for a great finish in Starkville. Thank you, gentlemen. We are just about 7 minutes away from Terrence Phillips, one of the many freshmen, the quartet of freshmen for Kim Anderson's squad. They are about 7 minutes away from tip-off against North Carolina State, hoping to get a W. And I know the kids went home for Christmas break, so we'll see how big a crowd that is. It's a crowd here at the SEC Network. Peter Burns, Glenn Big Baby Davis, and Damian Fishback. Quickly, one key for Missouri Tigers coming up in this game.
Well, I think they got to get out and run and transition and obviously focus on Cat Barber.
Start early on the defensive end and everything else will fall in place.
Cat Barber, get to know that name, that young man, 21 points a game. So we'll see these guys and myself at the half. But right now, Andy DeMito and John Sunvall are on the call at Mizzou Arena. Enjoy the game.
Welcome to SEC Network Basketball. Tonight we're at Mizzou Arena in Columbia for a matchup between the NC State Wolfpack and the Missouri Tigers. The former NBA Missouri guard John Sunvold, I'm Andy Demetrium. And John, the big question tonight for this young Missouri team, can they put the clamps at NC State's outstanding guard, Cat Barber?
Andy, they must contain this guy. If I'm a head coach, here's what I want my lead guard to do. 26 points, 6 assists, 5 rebounds, 0 turnovers, and then hit the game-winning shot. This guy's outstanding, one of the top lead guards in the country. Missouri must contain him. And on the other side, Missouri's got 2 freshmen they rely heavily upon. Kevin Purrier in his first year struggled against Arizona, but has been outstanding in this building. And the freshman, Terrence Phillips, the point guard, the lead guard for this team. He must contain Cat Barber, but also on the other end, run the show and see if they can get easy buckets.
Now, both being the starting lineup for the Tigers, along with Damon Wright, the senior Wes Clark, and senior Ryan Rosberg, Barber, Martin, Rowan, Malik Abu, and Anya round out the 5 for NC State. Missouri, undefeated this year in their home building, 5-0, but still in search of their first win over a major conference opponent.
They have struggled with physical play, and I would expect North Carolina State, which is one of the top offensive rebounding teams, they will pound it. Now, North Carolina State's got to stay out of foul trouble. They are very thin.
They have 7 healthy scholarship guys for this matchup tonight.
Man-to-man defensively by this Missouri Tiger team. North Carolina State is a ball club scoring just under 80 points, but at times struggles shooting the ball.
Steal by Phillips. Clark will take it inside, underneath, and the right line for you.
Good start for Missouri. Aggressive offensively after the steal. This is a team, again, they rely on a little momentum. They're a young team. If they get down, sometimes they stay down. Get up, get on a roll at home. They're 5-0 in this building. They've been much more comfortable.
You're the Tigers' leading scorer, but held to a season-low 4 points in that loss to Arizona. 3 by Barber.
The matchup that's interesting, Caleb Martin at 6'7", was being guarded by the 6'2", Wes Clark. They didn't find him inside, didn't give it to him. They sagged off Barber, made him shoot the 3-pointer. Mark Gottfried said earlier, we talked about it before the game, he said, we just want to contain the quickness of this Missouri team. They're good off the dribble. If they get comfortable, they're much better.
Clark, step back, short, altered well by Martin, and a foul in backcourt on the Tigers. You mentioned Mark Gottfried, and his 5th year has led NC State to the NCAA tournament. Each of his first 4 years in search of win number 100 as head coach of the Pack tonight.
Well, all he does is win. Everywhere he's been, Murray State, Alabama, North Carolina State, he wins. Elite 8, Sweet 16s, won a national championship as an assistant coach at UCLA. As a player, went to the NCAA 3 times. Had a great team last year. The Wolfpack went to the Sweet 16. Trevor Lacy left unexpectedly. They thought they'd have him back for a senior season.
Barber doesn't get the roll. Missouri cleans up the glass. A short-handed team that Mark Gottfried brings into Columbia tonight.
And again, if you're the home team, anytime a team comes in, travels as far as this team did, North Carolina State, you want to run early. You want to push the tempo. You want the crowd involved. Good block.
Yep. Rejected by Anya. And that's no surprise. B.J. Anya leading the ACC in blocks. 2nd active in blocks in the ACC.
Big body, 6'9", 285. And that's down from the mid-300s when he showed up.
He is still alone. Phillips, the freshman with the matchup on Cat Barber, coming off 26 points and 37 in the win earlier this year against Winthrop as Martin is off the mark.
And right now, North Carolina State, a little slow offensively. Their moves aren't very hard. They're easy to guard. They're standing. They're watching. Not enough emotion, not enough effort going on their offensive end.
NC State team still struggling to score this early season. Rosberg working on Anya again.
Rosberg not a big scorer. They're going to throw it to him. It looks like Kim Anderson's thinking if we can get some fouls on this North Carolina State team.
And it'll be an offensive foul as Clark had the free hand out extended against his defender. Kim Anderson, his second season as head coach of his alma mater. By the way, a very successful tenure down the road in Central Missouri, culminated in the 2014 Division II National Championship.
Big Eight Player of the Year back in 1977. We saw the national championship that he won a couple years ago. Frustrated a little bit last year. Their team was young. They're still young. He's led this year by his freshman players.
And 10 freshmen and sophomores in Kim Anderson's lineup this year.
He made a comment this week in the papers. They're taking two steps up and maybe one huge step back when they played these games 2-on-1.
Steve gets the turnover. Wright can't finish. Kept alive by Isabel. Open three. That's off the mark from Wright. Loose ball foul against NC State. Missouri being active on the glass. And that was something Kim Anderson talked about as an ingredient for his team's success tonight.
Yeah, I mentioned in the opening, they have struggled against the bigger teams that they've played, whether it's Xavier, whether it's Kansas State, where it's Arizona, around the rim. And either team so far could kind of grab this game early, but no one is, Andy. They're not shooting the ball well. You miss a layup on one end. Oh, good backdoor cut. Again, I think the Wolfpack is a little bit asleep, and Mark Guthrie calls a timeout, and he's got to get their energy up to a different level.
K.J. Walton, the freshman off the bench with the finish, and a frustrated Mark Guthrie following that lapse off the baseline inbounds.
Well, no communications, and Cat Barber doesn't have his hands up on the on ball. Nothing's going on, so that's an easy layup. This is a type of game for North Carolina State. It's on the road. It's an SEC team. It's a resume game. They have a chance to get a win when you come in to play a team like Missouri that's not one of the powerhouse teams, but you don't want to have that as a loss on your resume. And Mark Guthrie knows that. His guys, there is no energy right now, and Missouri's trying to find a way to jumpstart their season.
In a battle on Wednesday, we've got the win over High Point 76-73 all time. These teams meeting for a fifth time. Last did it 2 years ago, won by Missouri in Raleigh, 68-64.
You know, this is a team, NC State, that they thought they'd probably have Trevor Lacy back. He left. He decided to go pro. He's playing overseas. Terry Henderson, the outstanding transfer from West Virginia, hurt the first ball game, so he's out. A different-looking squad than they probably thought they would have last spring.
Cody Martin can't finish underneath. Out of bounds to Missouri, but you saw Cody Martin on that baseline dribble drive. They didn't think that they'd have him available. He sprained his ankle in the closing seconds of that High Point game. It was a game-time decision, so there was a possibility entering tonight, John, that NC State could have had six scholarship players.
What's great about Cody Martin, he can guard about four spots. He can guard the four-man, but he's going to guard the point guard, Phillips, when he gets in there, even on a bad week.
Barber finally puts the Wolfpack on the board.
Think about Barber, beside, we talk about his speed, but he's got good size. At 6'2", 190, solid. The upper body solid. He doesn't get knocked off his base when he's penetrating the basket. And he can rebound, and then they just go.
Preseason second team all ACC. And offense will run through number 12.
And the shot he made against High Point was not designed for him. It came down the stretch. He made a terrific back step. Freed himself up for the game winner.
Averaging 21 points a game, drawing a lot of attention early. Anya with the spin, right into a defender. Offensive foul as he plowed over Russell Woods. So Missouri up early, 4-2 over NC State. Just getting started here in Columbia. Missouri with the early 4-2 lead over NC State here in Columbia, Missouri. Glad you're along tonight on SEC Network. Andy DeMetra, John Sunvold, and John, Missouri's still looking for its first win over a Power 5 opponent. 0-4, and those losses have been by an average of 19 points. It'll take some of the intangibles for them to be competitive tonight.
Well, all those tough games were away from this building, and they were neutral site or on the road. Now, you've got a team coming in like North Carolina State on your home court. They've got to be physical. They've got to push it. What a home team wants to do, especially if you're young, get this home crowd involved. Get a couple steals, push and make some easy baskets. You can't miss those layups like they've already missed one. If they can get the crowd involved, then put North Carolina State on their heels, maybe then the Tar Heels will struggle a little bit, maybe with foul trouble. But right now, it's only a 4-2 ball game. Wolfpack's fine. I don't think their head coach is too happy there.
No, as we saw during that timeout with Mark Gottfried. But because Missouri has a little more depth than NC State, is that something where they can wear down the Wolfpack as this game goes on?
Well, you would expect the tempo, but I don't think too many players, especially the guards, worry about minutes. Obviously, this is a team, North Carolina State, that Cat Barber plays 38 minutes a game, Maverick Rowan 34 minutes, Caleb Martin 36 minutes. These guys are used to it. I think Mark Godfrey understands when he gives guys rest, you know, in between when they travel and maybe not a shoot around this morning and things they do that gets guys rested.
A little pressure in the backcourt. Two point guards on the floor. Terrence Phillips, the freshman, on the dribble right now. Tremaine Isabel is backup. Now takes the touch out front.
I love the versatility. I already mentioned Cody Martin at 6'7", guard to Terrence Phillips. He's got size on him. He's got to stay in front of him. Phillips pretty good with the basketball.
Shot clock winding down. Isabel brings it down.
Isabel, a sophomore this season. Fewer minutes than a year ago. That is his fifth three-pointer, 5 of 9 beyond the arc. Doesn't shoot a lot of them, but very confident when he gets his game going, when he has the basketball and his quickness. Garfield High School out of Seattle.
Anya giving space. Finally hands off to Caleb Martin, 14 points a game. Off the mark on his first attempt.
You notice when Anya had the ball, Russell Woods just sagged off it. He's just going to play center field. They're going to make him make a play.
Gottfried said coming in, he wants more production out of his bigs.
Four fresh bodies in for Missouri. Even though we're early in this game, you can tell that Kim Anderson's going to use a number of players. Good pass.
Underneath Woods, the dump down, great vision, and he hits Jakinen Gant for the lay-in.
Rarely do you want your big guys to make an extra pass when they're 4 feet from the bucket, but that was a good one. Woods went up and saw an open teammate.
Love the old big-to-big passing. Yeah. Russell Woods, the sophomore, Jakinen Gant, who's really come on the last several games off the bench for Kim Anderson.
Gant may be a key to Missouri being a better team in the SEC. Only a sophomore season, highly recruited out of Georgia.
Randy pulled up by Cat Barber.
Partner trying to stay in front of that. That's tough to do.
Wears that nickname well, doesn't he?
Yep.
Phillips will hand off with Isabel.
What I like about North Carolina State, their team now on the floor, is that their length. They can really guard. They can switch out.
Walden, the freshman, working on Barber. The shot clock at 2. Lost his balance, and they'll call him for steps.
Well, the object on the offensive end for Missouri is to be active, be aggressive off the dribble. And when they do that, they find open shooters. Isabel knocks that first one in, and here's the pass inside. Russell Woods finding teammate Gant. Good passing, but again, it's movement. It's making the defense move, making the defense help out. And when you do that, you'll find open teammates.
And something the Tigers wanted to do tonight was to be aggressive off the dribble, get that ball to the rim.
Their strength, I would say, this Missouri team is the fact they've got enough guys that can take people off the bounce.
Rowan off the dribble. Missouri also doing a good job on the glass. How many offensive rebounds for what can be a good offensive rebounding team as Gant hits the mid-range jumper.
I've already talked about it. His last three ball games, 11, 11, and 8. I mean, everything seems to be his confidence is going upward, and Kim Anderson needs it.
Barber with the answer, getting back to Gant. His best games have come after a demotion. He started the first four games, but has really re-emerged off the bench.
And he's a kid that it really becomes a confidence issue. 6'8", 215, everybody likes his athletic ability. When you watch him shoot, he looks like a good shooter, has not shot the ball yet, though, in games. So it's becoming a confidence issue. And when a younger player starts feeling better about his game and confidence, it changes the way he plays, changes the way his team can play.
Cullen Van Leer for 3.
Another freshman. Spot-up shooter. Most of his attempts this year, he's taken 42 field goal attempts, 38 of them have been three-point shots.
He's held scoreless for the first time all season in that loss to Arizona. His first touch and his first three-pointer. And the Tigers have an 8-point lead, their largest.
Cat Barber's trying to figure out who else on the offensive end will be involved for the Wolfpack.
Offensive rebound. And a foul called Lenard Freeman. Wolfpack's leading rebounder draws the foul. But Missouri has the 14-6 lead. Almost 50% of the Tigers' points come from freshmen. Cullen Van Leer, the freshman from downtown. Welcome back to Columbia. Among those in attendance today, those middle schoolers from Warsaw, Missouri, just south of Sedalia. And you see them all wearing identical t-shirts and holding up a check. They've raised money for the family of Missouri assistant coach Brad Luce, whose daughter Ryan, who's 5 years old, is battling stage 4 neuroblastoma, a very rare form of pediatric cancer. There's been such a tremendous outpouring of support from the entire Missouri community, including the team managers for these Missouri Tigers, who pooled their money together to give Ryan an early Christmas gift of a full-size stuffed tiger. And you see Ryan in the middle, clearly liking that present, so brave in fighting this rare form of cancer, neuroblastoma. And John, you being here and having your roots here, you can appreciate just how much the community has wrapped its arms around Coach Luce and his daughter.
Yeah, this community in the state has been terrific for Jennifer and Brad Luce, their son Brady, and the other daughter Charlie, and the coaching community throughout the country, and student athletes around the country. When Missouri student athletes from all sports travel, they seem to get other student athletes from those events, whether it's golf, whether it's volleyball, whether it's soccer, women's basketball, that they've been all involved for Ryan Luce, and it's been really special to watch.
See the backs of the t-shirts, we rally for Ryan. So get a look at Coach Luce. And we tip our caps to those middle schoolers for their efforts raising money for a very worthy family. Leonard Freeman at the line, sinks the first, the junior from Washington, D.C. He's come off the bench the last three contests for Mark Godfrey, but still leads them in rebound.
Another Oak Hill Academy kid, as the Martin twins are, as is Terrence Phillips, teammates at Oak Hill. So I'm sure there was a little reunion before the game, little smiles on each other's faces, probably some tweets going out during this week about which team's a little better for this afternoon's game, who gets the bragging rights.
I'm going to venture to guess Oak Hill won a lot of games when those guys were there.
Yeah, I think so. I think Terrence Phillips, his last 2 years, they were 88-4, I read. Now think of it, 88, that's 92 ball games in 2 years. I don't know how you get to play that many.
Pretty high percentage. Transition three, Martin. Can't follow his own miss. Van Leer grabs the board.
I thought Martin got bumped just enough on his wrist. He wasn't happy. Looked at the official.
Martin does lead the Wolfpack in three-point attempts.
And has improved immensely over a year ago in the three-point shooting.
Tigers, though, still early, doubling up the Wolfpack.
And usually when you watch a game, you want to see how easily an offensive team can move the ball. And right now, Missouri's having no problems moving it side to side, in to out, swinging. And when you do that, you get easy shots. So what it says is the Wolfpack just hasn't stepped up defensively yet. Their energy's not there. And if they allow Missouri to get point-blank shots like that one, they're going to have a successful day.
Isabel rearranging his body in midair, and Tremaine Isabel, the sophomore, with five. Bench production for Missouri. Barber wants to clear out and go to work. Shot clock is at three. So smooth, Cat Barber.
Well, he has shown up, right? He's got to find some teammates. Or the other option would be Cat just takes the rest of the shots. They've not been able to defend him. They've not been able to bother him and get him away from what he wants to do. As a lead guard so far, he's tried to get other guys involved, but maybe he just needs to keep going himself and let the other guys catch up.
He's got 8 of the Wolfpack's 9 points. Much more balance for the Tigers.
Again, ball movement inside to outside. No bothersome by the North Carolina State team.
Van Leer, the pump and the triple to beat the shot clock.
Two freshmen, Van Leer and Rowan, shooter against shooter. We should know how to guard each other. Rowan took the ball fake. Van Leer, good sidestep for a three.
And Mizzou Arena roaring to life with the lead in double digits. A team that has labored through a 5-4 start. Coming off a 40-plus point loss, their last outing versus number 13 Arizona.
Wow,
off the window, Malik Abu.
What a tough finish. Has played well last two ball games. 11-14 at South Florida, 13-9 against High Point. One of those guys that Mark Godfrey said, we got to get going inside.
And Lear with the heat check, can't get it to go.
That's a freshman, just heat check whenever you want to.
Barber spinning away from two defenders, pass is batted by Gantz. Run out Isabel. He'll take it to the goal and wave it off an offensive foul. It'll be Isabel's first.
Opportunities missed sometimes. Two on one, good take by Martin. Really, when you see a guy start to plan, if you can just plant yourself, little kickoff, he had a layup for a teammate on the right. Good minutes, though, by Isabel for Kim Anderson.
He'll come out, and Terrence Phillips takes his place.
Naaman Wright defensively on Maverick Rowan's. Got to stay home. Rowan, an outstanding shooter, goes in streaks, only a freshman, but he can light it up.
Anya, the kick out to Barber. Beautiful. And he is on fire right now. Give him 11 points.
And Terrence Phillips turned his head, and Barber smart enough to just slide over. And so when Phillips tried to get back into where he was, Barber on fire, coming off a terrific game, a high point, continues his score.
That three-pointer there. He only had one three-pointer all season entering that high point game. Turnaround is short. Off the mark by Puryear.
Puryear, the leading scorer for Missouri, has been quiet so far this afternoon.
And a hedge out on Barber.
Good job by Barber, because he drags a hedge so far out. There should be numbers behind it if they can make the pass. Smart play. Didn't get a bucket.
Phillips slicing his way through and finishes with the left hand. Terrence Phillips, the freshman, and the younger brother of Detroit Pistons point guard Brandon Jennings.
Got a good thought process on how he plays. He talks about how Brandon Jennings reminds him every day you got to work at it and keep pushing yourself to be good.
A fearless finish. Rowan from way downtown.
Mark Gottfried said, you know what, we need him to shoot. We've got to have him shoot, and maybe that's not the role we thought he would be as a freshman, because of injuries, we must have him take shots that maybe we wouldn't thought he would have taken when we're looking at this summer.
And he was the guy who reclassified up to the class of 2015. This should technically be his senior year of high school. Off balance, Wright can't get it to go. Rosberg chases it down, saves possession for the Tigers. Van Leer will crank one up. This time, the rebound to the Wolfpack. So a little more energy of late from this NC State team.
I guess if it feels like leather, you just shoot it. I mean, we've got two guys that just loading up from deep. Derek Wittenberg, the great North Carolina State player, is in the house as assistant athletic director, and I'm thinking that's how Witt used to do it. We're catching him and shooting. Here's a tough matchup. Phillips has got to stay in front of Barber. Barber's on a roll. Oh, that's tough.
Corner doesn't fall for Rowan, and a loose ball foul going against the Tigers and Rosberg. Colin Van Leer, part of a hot shooting start for the Missouri Tigers. The relocation and the finish, and the Tigers have the 4-point lead. Missouri with the 21-17 lead over NC State with 6:07 to play in the first half here from Columbia, Missouri. Make sure you stay tuned as we cap off our full day and night of college hoops on the SEC ESPN Network with Damian Jones and the Commodores taking on Wofford. The game will also be streaming live on Watch ESPN. A Vanderbilt team that began the year in the top 25 has since been bounced out. Lost Luke Cornett to an injury, and he's a guy who can really stretch the floor for them.
Yeah, they've lost two in a row. Now let's think of their three losses. Kansas, one of the best teams in the country. Baylor, an outstanding team. And then the Dayton Flyers, who are really, really good. This Vandy team, I think, will compete for an SEC championship. They get everybody healthy. If guys shoot the ball like they're capable of shooting, it is a very dangerous team.
Yeah, all those shooters they have. You catch them on the wrong night.
Oh, boy. They're an entertaining team to watch. Again, Coach Stallings would say, yeah, we are when we're making shots. He would agree with that. There are some nights they may not shoot as well, but I think they're deep enough to make some pretty good runs.
Martin, 4-3.
Flat shot, looked like tired legs.
And a Martin, second in the ACC in three-pointers per game, and averages over three.
And if you're a shooter and you're tired, shoot the shot earlier on your jump. Release it earlier as you go up than the ball's going up. Puryear pretty quality minutes for Isabel. Sat out a couple, came back in.
Rosberg, the duck in, and they'll tag him for six. Fifth turnover for the Tigers.
And Rosberg, not the number one option offensively, but what I think they're trying to do is just put pressure in the inside against North Carolina State, looking for foul problems. But Anya stayed on the floor, not bothered by what Rosberg was going to do to him.
NC State is a team that has struggled scoring from outside this year. Barber has not had that issue. The shot clock at five. Slices through the screen, and he gets fouled on the jumper.
You know, 5 of 7 from the field. He looks comfortable at getting his shot when he wants to get his shot. He has spent most of this first half trying to get his teammates going, running the offense, because as a lead guard, you're trying to do what coaches say. Hey, let's get everybody involved. But what I like what he's done is when he has noticed there's nothing there, get it yourself, keep us close, and see if everybody falls along, and right now they're only 4 points down.
A rare sight there is he misses the free throw. Team best 86%, but what is not a rare sight, John, the fact that Cat Barber is at the free throw line. He's second in the nation. 87 made free throws and give him an 88.
Because of his aggressive play, it's hard to stay in front. With the new rules, right, you can't bump him. He understands it. Now, a year ago, he was a 73% free throw shooter. So you can see the improvement over the summertime. His work, basically going to the free throw line and making free throws.
Isabel was marooned, calls timeout for Missouri as NC State has crept back to within three. Like we said, these teams meeting for a fifth time. Last time they did it was 2 years ago. Missouri was 25th ranked, and these teams met in December of 2013. NC State's top scorer and the ACC's top scorer, T.J. Warren, scored 10 of his game-high 24 in the first 10 minutes. But Missouri rallied back in the second half. They took their first lead on that Jordan Clarkson three-pointer. And then with just under a minute left, Jabari Brown hit a three-pointer that gave Missouri the lead for good. Brown finished the night with 17. Clarkson led the Tigers with 21 in a 68-64 win to stop a seven-game NC State win streak. And that win also the last time Missouri has beaten a power conference, non-conference opponent 0 for the last 10.
Here, you look at those highlights and you think Jordan Clarkson now making his name with the Lakers in his second season. Outstanding pro Jabari Brown played for the Lakers last season.
And Ever Growing called for the personal.
Perrier's been quiet for Missouri. North Carolina State's got a nice job of denying him the basketball and then containing him when he gets it.
That was Naaman Wright on the drive. He draws the foul on Martin, and that is something the sophomore Naaman Wright has done a much better job of this year, John, is getting to the free throw line.
He has taken more free throws and made more free throws already this season than he did all of last season. About 3 weeks ago, Kim Anderson really publicly called Naaman Wright out and said we need him to play well, especially offensively, for us to be better. Now in his sophomore season, Naaman Wright, like any freshman or sophomores, up and down. But a year ago, he had 28 points against Florida, capable of making shots. But it's a consistency that every coach looks for in players, and that's what Kim Anderson has won. And Naaman Wright has stepped up his game at times and played pretty well.
His first point of the contest, Tigers lead is 4. Martin cranks up the 3. This is not a shy outside shooting at Wolfpack team. As ball will stay on this end.
Well, if they get open looks, they're going to take them. And that time, Missouri was in a 2-3 zone defense. It swung quickly to Caleb Martin. He missed his third shot that he's taken from deep this afternoon.
Phillips will be whistled for the foul. And tangled up with Barber. That is Terrence Phillips' second. And also the team's 7th, so a 1-1 for Cat Barber. Bring Van Leer in. Hard to keep Cat Barber in front of you without trying to clutch and grab.
Well, and there's a difference between a junior and a freshman. I mean, Barber kind of had Phillips on his hip, played a little bit, but kept him on his hips no matter where Phillips tried to go. Barber kept him there, and the official blew the whistle. Smart play. You go to the free throw line, make two free throws.
And Auburn now makes it a two-point game, an 11-3 Wolfpack run. Cody Martin subs in for his twin, Caleb Martin. 6'7".
And Missouri coaching staff says, now don't be confused, guys. They look the same. Their bodies are the same. But they do play a little bit differently.
Godfrey got the old 2-for-1 special on the recruiting trail. Crossover. Isabel flunked it up and in.
Tough finish.
Very strong first half for Isabel.
I said earlier, he is a confidence type player. If he makes one or two, he will continue his attack pretty quick with the dribble.
Came in averaging just 4.6 points a game. He's got 7. Rowan. Can't get that pull-up three. Rosberg tears down the rebound. Isabel looking for more. Rosberg can't get his hands on the stick in.
Numbers now.
Barber behind the back. Contested well and taken away. Challenged by Wright and pulled away by Isabel. And now a three by Naaman Wright spins out.
Wow, good defense on one end by Wright. Couldn't get one to down. Now got an open up and down pace. But Isabel has been the guy that has come off the bench for Kim Anderson. Missouri up 4, but Isabel off the dribble, been able to hit from the outside, and has been terrific when he makes these kind of moves and these kind of finishes.
Thanks, guys. Missouri has led the entire first half, but trying to fend off Cat Barber, who's got 14 of the Wolfpack's 20 points.
Well, coming in, we focused on Cat Barber and that Missouri would have to try to stop him. They've done a nice job, but Cat Barber has done what he really wants to do when he wants to do it. He's been terrific shooting the ball. He's been terrific running the show. His teammates have not really followed along, but he's been good. 5 of 7 from the field. He's got 3 rebounds. He's got an assist. As good as advertised when he walked into this building.
I need some help.
Yeah, I think so. There's the fine line when you're the lead guy out front is how much do I keep doing and how much do I try to get everybody involved? And the idea is to get guys involved. But I think what he's done is a great mixture of saying, okay, I'm going to get enough that keeps us in striking distance, and someone else is going to follow along in the second half.
Freshman Maverick Rowan will try to oblige with 1-1 out of the timeout. Missouri with the rebound. But getting back to Cat Barber, not only is he second in the ACC, 21 points per game, but, John, he leads the Wolfpack in assists almost 6 a contest.
Yeah, and again, 38 minutes a night, every night. When you're the guy and have to do it, he has responded.
Harden lobbing to Anya. DJ Anya, 285 pounds, putting that muscle to good use.
How about the patience, right? Took his time. There's no double team. Made sure he gathered himself. And really, the last bounce was the hardest bounce, the firmest, that got him into a pretty good little jump hook.
He came in averaging 74% from the field. Two-point game again. Isabel leads the Tigers in scoring, trying to dish underneath the ricochet to Gans and the flush.
It worked out. Good look and find by Isabel off of K.J. Walton, and then Woods with the flush.
Russell Woods, the junior college transfer originally from Chicago.
I was going to say, why not go right back to where the last play was?
Quick feet. Anya can't follow his own miss. Abu now off the window.
Mark Gottfried has last two possessions said we're going to pound it into our size. And we talked on the opening that Missouri's had an issue with size this year. They're not the thickest type players in this Missouri uniform.
Abdul Malik Abu with 4 points. Of course, he had that game-winning buzzer beater against LSU in the NCAA tournament a year ago.
Challenge for Rowan defensively will be to stay in front of K.J. Walton. Walton really good off the dribble, gets to the paint. Rowan's got to move his feet.
NC State forces a tough shot out of Isabel. To tie, perhaps take their first lead of the half. Barber knifing his way through, and we are all level.
Wow. In my mind, I was thinking he has yet to force a bad shot or even think about it. What a finish.
Wolfpack have erased a 10-point deficit. Three, no good by K.J. Walton. Barber will have that ball on a string. Screen from Anya.
Look how he brings the two defenders out. That's the key to that is for another teammate to be in position to get a quick pass for Barber, and then there'll be a mismatch inside.
Shot clock at six. Barber bearing down on Russell Woods. A shake, a shot. They can't get the field goal. Now quickly a 2-on-1 for the Tigers. Woods with another jam.
Plenty of time for one last shot for North Carolina State.
Missouri the lead again. Barber. Buzzer beater for the lead, and NC State's first lead of the half comes on the Kent Barber three to beat the buzzer.
How about that first half? Teammates didn't play with him, and Kent Barber took completely over this first half of this ballgame.
Almost matching his season average with 19 first half points.
He delays the bounce until the very end. He just sized it up. He bounced and bounced. You weren't quite sure he was going to get the shot off, but he knew he was. And the reaction.
It's a chunk of 19 points for the junior Kent Barber. And as a result, NC State will head into the locker room with its first lead. We'll go inside the studios as we've hit halftime here in Columbia.
All right, thank you, gentlemen. Welcome into the State Farm Halftime Report. I'm Peter Burns. That is Glenn Big Baby Davis and that pretty flower right there on his jacket. And Damian Fishback. And it was looking good for Mizzou for that entire first half until that last shot. NC State, the Wolfpack, take the lead on that last shot of the half. What did you see from Kim Anderson's squad?
Well, I thought that they did a good job of playing together as a unit. Let's remember, this is a team that's had some depth. Nice bench production. They'll have to continue to keep that up and then really just play some gang defense against Kent Barber. He's playing sensational
basketball. Kent Barber has been fantastic. When a guy like that, Big Baby, is playing incredible, how do you stop him in that second half?
Just get the ball out of his hands. Make sure he passes the ball to the next player, because if he's hot like that, you know, he's going to kill you.
Yeah, you saw that out of Stephon Moody a couple nights ago. We'll see if all of a sudden Kim Anderson can go ahead and try to shut down him after 19 in the first in just a moment. But right now, Isabel hits a three. Nice little basket from that young man, but Missouri's down one to the Wolfpack at half.
This halftime report is presented by State Farm. It pays to double check. Talk to your agent today.
And you want bunnies? How about this one? Russell Woods. Well, it wasn't that easy, but a good play. He's got four to break, but Mizzou's down by one at half. Well, we said before the game here in the State Farm Halftime Report that they were going to have to contain Kent Barber. They did not. 19 points to the Missouri Tigers, down one at half to NC State.
This halftime report is presented by State Farm. It pays to double check. Talk to your agent today. Welcome back to SEC Network Basketball Halftime in Missouri. The Tigers trailing NC State by a score of 29-28. Andy DeMetra, John Sunvold, and if you're Kim Anderson, I'm sure you spent a lot of time in the locker room talking about how to limit Kent Barber. 19 first half points for the Wolfpack.
You know, hard to stop him because he's the guy with the ball all the time. I thought it was the easiest 19 I've seen in a long time because Kent Barber didn't force a shot. He didn't force the action. He just took it when it was there. He tried to get his teammates involved. They didn't follow along for a while, and he just controlled the first half. Kind of fun to watch.
That being said, Missouri ought to feel a little encouraged because their two leading scorers, Phillips and Puryear, combined for just 4 points as we get a look at how Barber got his 19.
Yeah, Barber did it in a mix of different ways, and at the end of the half, he knocks it in right at the buzzer. And again, he controlled everything about how cool and calm he was. And for Missouri, 23 of the 28 points came from off the bench, and Tremaine Isabel was spectacular. 3 of 5 from the field, made shots, drove the ball, had some assists. Kim Anderson's got to be pleased with his bench, but his scorers really, or starters really struggled.
See how even it was in that first half. Bench points dominated by Missouri. Not much bench to speak of for this NC State team that's only dressing 7 healthy scholarship guys.
They play 2 guys off the bench. I'll be curious to see if Missouri, the home team, can pick up the pace, which gets your home crowd involved, or does North Carolina State continue to control as they did the last 7 minutes of that first half, how they want to play and keep the crowd out of it.
Missouri led by as many as 10 in the first half. Anya.
Caleb Martin, one of those guys that struggled the first half, 0 of 5 from the field, and they rely on his scoring.
Rosberg fouls Anya.
Think of Caleb Martin at 14 points a game, Maverick Rowan at 14 points a game. Those are the 2 guys I would think that will try to find ways to get involved more offensively.
That was Rosberg 2nd. Not the worst thing to send B.J. Anya to the line, just 34% on the year. ACC's active leader in blocks. Probably heard me. That's why I made it.
So his percentage, if he misses this one, goes up. 1 of 2, it goes up. That's rarely said.
Yeah.
But you know what? He has good rotation on it. He had a soft touch on the first one. That one is in and out. Main thing most guys struggle with is just the confidence of thinking they're going to make the shot.
Phillips will raise up and knock down the 3.
Very comfortable at shooting 3s. Doesn't shoot a lot of them, but 40% for the year. Has some good range.
All-time assist leader in Oak Hill Academy history. Terrence Phillips has 5.
Both teams offensively have tried to play from the inside out, and they're going to 2 offensive players, and neither one are big numbers. Anya's got 6 a game. Rosberg averages 4 a game. But again, when the ball goes in, there seems to be better rotation offensively. Good pass.
Abu with the foul.
What a sleight of hand pass by Maverick Rowan. The shooter, they came out to him quickly because he was open. A little ball fake, put 1 bounce on it, and he fired it to Abu. Good hands, good catch, and even a better finish. There's a ball fake. 2 guys. Scouting report said can't let Rowan open, and when he had it, 2 guys left him. And instead of shooting it, good sideways bounce, fired it inside.
That foul also Rosberg's 3rd. That'll chase the Missouri Tigers big man to the bench. Teams have traded leads in the opening 2 minutes of the second half.
Currier, leading scorer for Missouri all season long, is 1 of 2. Only 2 field goal attempts, made the first shot of the ballgame.
Ball will stay with Missouri, but how do you get Kevin Currier more involved?
Well, again, as a freshman, the scouting reports are now out there. They're defending him quite well. They've got a big body on him, and Currier can step away and make shots. He's not a great 3-point shooter. He'll make a few now and then. He'll take them. But they have not been able to find any space for him to even take a look.
Shot clock winding down. Phillips, another 3. This one doesn't fall.
Not many offensive rebound looks for this Missouri team. North Carolina State big, physical. They rebound the ball well.
Interception. Bright read the eyes. Bright coast to coast, and he got fouled.
And Andy, that pace right there is what a home crowd wants. A little bit of a push, a little bit of a kick, and you get a foul.
So as Wright goes to the free throw line, don't forget Sunday night on the SEC ESPN Network, we've got 2 top 20 women's teams squaring off with number 13 Duke battles number 8 Kentucky, and Michaela Epps, the ESPNW National Player of the Week last Sunday, starts at 7 Eastern on the SEC ESPN Network, also streaming live on Watch ESPN.
I got to see Kentucky Wildcats, the ladies' practice last year. I'll take Michaela Epps and you can have the rest of it. I'm good to go. She's on my team. She's dynamite.
Wright splits the free throws. How about the Missouri women's team? A school record 10-0 start.
Yep, undefeated.
Take on Lamar here tomorrow.
A few local products from Rockbridge High School that won 4 state championships in a row.
And there's that first 3 from Martin.
That looks comfortable.
Stretches the Wolfpack lead to 4.
They're interchangeable parts again defensively. They can switch, they can guard with their bigger size.
Anya alters that shot from Woods.
Hard to score inside against this Wolfpack team.
Entry pass was kicked. Well, the good news is Missouri has held Camp Barber scoreless in the second half, but now getting his teammates involved.
Yeah, 0-5 first half, we talked about it. Caleb Martin can shoot it, can stroke it, and if he gets his confidence going, and I think his game's getting better because defensively he's picked it up, that's gotten him into the game. He'll probably knock this one in. He made the last one.
Oh, you were almost right. And a loose ball foul against Missouri. As the Blue grabbed that rebound.
The first half, Andy, we talked about North Carolina State picking up their energy. Now they have done that. Missouri's got to respond. A team that has struggled against bigger, stronger teams, but this young squad of Missouri has to get active defensively, make a stop or two, because this Wolfpack now are on a roll.
As Rowan buries it, in the lead out to six. Perrier. I'll try to quiet that. And they'll call the foul on the boot.
You know, Perrier's got a set of skills offensively that can post guys. He can step out. He can make a shot. At 6'7", he's not a power guy, but powerful enough that he can back guys in. Left-handed, has a good left-hand jump hook. Can go back to his right hand, can face up, make outside shots.
Kansas City star, All-Metro Player of the Year. Yes, almost thrown away. Has also been bottled up. He gets it going though.
High school confidence. A guy that Missouri will rely upon this season in his junior year now. He's been around more than any of the other players.
Team's leading returning scorer. His first bucket of the game and an offensive foul on Anya. Trying to clear space on Woods. That guy might hold the key to Missouri's fortunes in SEC play, the junior Wes Clark.
Yeah, I think, you know, when you're looking for leadership and you've got a young team, different guys have to step up. And Wes Clark has been a guy on different nights this season because he's a junior. Sat out much of the SEC last year, got hurt. And at that time in SEC play, he was averaging nearly 12 points a ballgame. Hurt the elbows, come back, has struggled with his shooting. But that doesn't seem to bother him. I mean, he still has to take a leadership role, and he'll take big shots for this team.
Dishing. Doesn't fall, but a foul. Wright will go to the line. As he draws to third on Maverick Rowan. And again, this short NC State bench. Mark Gottfried really can't afford foul trouble at any point in the game.
Yeah, these 4 minutes of this second half, I think, are better than any of the 20 in the first half. And I mean, the cuts are harder offensively. So the defenders are going to have to be better than they were in that first half. There's more movement going on. Guys are being more aggressive with the basketball. That was a good cut by Naaman Wright. Clark put it right on the money. Misses both free throws.
Wright has missed three free throws this game. Came in leading the Tigers 79%.
Yeah, that's one of the guys, again, we talked about his ability to score and shoot the ball. And this is a team that desperately needs their players to respond and make plays.
Remains a four-point Wolfpack lead. In a sixth game in their last seven. Hart tanked to the rim. Carter blocked by Gantz. But stolen right back by Martin.
Numbers.
Barber. And one.
Speed. You make a mistake on one end if you're Missouri. You've got numbers as you push. If you make a mistake, Cat Barber is going to take it the other way.
You can't kill what you can't catch. 21 for Cat Barber. Wolfpack up six. Mark Gottfried in NC State leading Missouri 40-34, 15-32 to play here at Mizzou Arena. Tuesday on the SEC ESPN Network, we've got a college basketball triple header beginning at 4 Eastern with Troy and Ole Miss. And at 6, it's Clemson at Georgia. And finally at 8, Ben Simmons and LSU host American. All games are also streaming live on Watch ESPN. And in that triple header, John, you will see some high-powered scores. Stephon Moody leads the SEC in scoring. Ben Simmons, we know all about him. And J.J. Frazier today, 35 points, 6 three-pointers as the Bulldogs defeated Georgia Tech.
Well, we know J.J. can do that. He had 37 last year in a ball game. We know what Ben Simmons can do. Moody is a guy that we marveled at last season. I marvel at again. Because he can be a one-man wrecking crew. I mean, he's unbelievable. He's physically strong. He's not tall. He had 21 last night in the win over Memphis. He can do some major damage to opposing coaches and their scouting reports, right? How do you guard a guy that's not overly big, but he's just so physically tough, and he shoots it from so deep and can attack a rim? Really fun to watch.
I like that he and Frazier are both members of the sub-6-foot club.
That's right.
Getting it done. This guy's also getting it done. Cat Barber completes the three-point play. Largest lead of the night for the Wolfpack.
Missouri needs to respond. Again, home team must get the crowd involved. North Carolina State has been better defensively.
Isabel still leads them in scoring.
Kim Anderson went right to his bench. Remember, they produced 23 of the 28 points in that first half. Three guys already in off the side. Isabel, Gant, Woods.
Clock at two through Isabel's hands. Martin now in the open floor, and it's an 8. They get a 9-point NC State lead.
And I couldn't tell if Isabel knew the clock was running out and didn't hustle for it, and because he didn't, Martin got a layup.
Kim Anderson wants to bring play to a halt. A timeout with 14:56 to play. His team led for most of the first half, but now trailing by 9. Missouri trailing NC State 43-34, second half of play in Columbia. Join us tonight at 10 p.m. on SEC ESPN Network as our network analysts discuss all the SEC news of the day on SEC Now, also streaming live on Watch ESPN. And John, let's take a look at some SEC news and notes. Kentucky today falling again to unranked Ohio State 74-67. Jamal Murray had 33 points. The rest of the Kentucky team had 34. And meanwhile, South Carolina, its best start in only 81 years. 10-0 after beating Clemson last night. Retno Basahan on the strength of a 23-point performance against that Clemson team, the reigning SEC Player of the Week. Alabama is another team that's turned heads this early season.
Yeah, I got to see Alabama on Wednesday night, and Basahan has turned into, we loved him when he first came in. We thought, what a good athlete, what a great kid. Speaks four languages. He was known really as a high flyer, right? An athletic guy. Now he's 6'2", strong body, offensive-minded player, a true leader for Avery Johnson, has taken over that role. And so Alabama, the wins they have this year, Notre Dame, Wichita State, some games that they wouldn't win and couldn't win a year ago, going to Clemson and winning. And the last few years, all those close ones, and Avery Johnson's got kids that are confident and excited to play, and they've been winning.
They have a guy who's an Eastern Conference Coach of the Year in the NBA. That also helps.
The kids like it. They listen. They've responded. And Avery told us he thought his team was better defensively than he thought they would be at this time. Just offensively, they still struggle like many of these teams do. Another missed shot.
And Missouri still struggling from the floor. Martin takes the bump and draws the foul.
And what has North Carolina State done is defensively they made a stop. First half, they kind of walked it up, right? The second half, it's a push. Mark Gottfried got some attention at halftime and said, okay, we've got through the 20 minutes of either being tired from other games, tired of traveling. Now we've got 20 minutes. We don't have foul problems. Guys, we got to go and we got to attack. We got a chance to win one on the road.
And now have the lead double digits. Rosberg will come in for Woods, who just collected his third foul.
And the value of having a lead guard for Mark Gottfried in Barber is the fact that Barber controlled the whole half and kept them in the game. When they were down early, made shots, they hung on until they played well defensively, and now all of a sudden they're on a roll in the second half.
They outscored the Tigers by 10 in the opening 5.5 minutes, and Barber only has 2 of those points.
And you wonder for Missouri, where are the answers on the offensive end? Who can make a shot? Who can get a shot against this tough North Carolina State team? Good move by Clark. Didn't finish.
Races down the loose carom, though, and a press 30 for the Tigers.
But again, where North Carolina State can defend you. The Martin brothers at 6'7", they can guard guards, makes it tough to shoot them.
Clark, the crossover. And a foul called on Barber.
Good crossover by Clark. I think he's been the best off the dribble for Missouri at causing things. Hasn't shot the ball well, but you have to keep going. You have to continue to attack and see what you can get. Now K.J. Walton comes in. He's another guy that can attack off the dribble.
It's good to see Clark on the floor. He has another off-the-ball foul whistled against NC State. I was at that game last year, February 10th,
yeah, you were doing
at South Carolina.
South Carolina.
Yeah, and he dislocated his elbow, and it was the most gruesome injury that I've ever seen on the basketball floor. And for obvious reasons, we won't show you the footage. He was out for 4 months. You wonder if there might be a little residual tentativeness with his form and his coordination getting his shot up. His shooting percentage is not where he's capable of having it so far.
Well, anytime you go through an injury on your shooting arm, shooting hand, shooting elbow, whatever, it's going to be a difference when you come back. And you talked about the injury. And at that time, he was averaging nearly 12 points a game in SEC play. As a sophomore, one of those kind of up-and-coming strong players. It's been a struggle for him this start of the season, just shooting the basketball.
All the way no good, but back tap by Martin to Barber. And the Barber shop is still open.
Now the beat goes on, huh?
24 for Cat Barber. Wall the other way gets hammered.
And I think Missouri, what they did that time, ball goes in the basket, they pushed it. I think they must open it up, whether it's successful or not, because their half-court offense, they are bottled up by this North Carolina State team. Their length and their size inside, Missouri gets nothing around the rim. So now you're thinking, okay, they've got to push. The bad part is they've not made free throws in their own building. And that's K.J. Walton's first free throw. It's the first guy to take a free throw outside of Naaman Wright. So they are now 2 of 7 from the foul line.
Walton considered the best of this freshman class for Kim Anderson, but an 0-for-2 trip. Brownsburg, Indiana, same hometown as current Utah Jazz forward Gordon Hayward.
And you know, Andy, you've seen teams with young guys that struggle. When things go bad, they kind of go bad, you know, unless you have a guy step up. And usually that's an upperclassman. And I'm going to say it again, Cat Barber stepped up for North Carolina State in that first half when they had nothing. But he's a junior, right? He knew that they needed something. And Missouri's just kind of searching. They've got young players, none of them overly confident that they can get the job done. Wes Clark, the junior, though, continues to fight and see if he can keep his guys in this.
We'll make it an 11-point game with 12 and a half to go. Clark coming off his best shooting game in that loss to Arizona. Martin, this fires out the three, Rosberg the rebound. In Missouri, trying to get a broken floor. Walton to the hole with the left hand.
Push and attack. And if you attack by the right guy, it's going to be pretty good. And K.J. Walton's one of those guys, and that gets the home crowd back into this arena.
Mark Gottfried will call timeout. You do wonder if those legs might be starting to get heavy for NC State. With that short bench is K.J. Walton, the freshman, trying to pull Missouri back level. Down 1 at halftime, now down 9 here in Columbia. Let's take a look at tonight's good hands play brought to you by Allstate. And for NC State, the junior guard, Cat Barber.
Well, all night long, he's had the best hands on the court. Active on defense, terrific on offense. No doubt at all, ACC player, and the step back at the buzzer to end the first half that gave North Carolina State their first lead, and they've been on top ever since.
Still has a ways to go to match his career high, which he set back November the 27th with 37 versus Winthrop, but 24 so far for the Wolfpack. And he's had to shoulder some more production because the guy they had penciled in as a starter in the backcourt, Terry Henderson, transferred from West Virginia, still out. He suffered ligament damage to his ankle, a couple of weeks away from rejoining the lineup.
Yeah, they talk 2 or 3 weeks away, and Mark Gottfried said, I hope so, but when he walks in with crutches, he goes, I'm not so sure. Averaged nearly 13 a game at West Virginia, and he was kind of supposed to be in the lineup.
Call the foul on Walton. Referee saying he got him on the elbow.
The crowd reaction is because the whistle was so late. He had taken the shot. He had missed a shot wide left. Now, he might have got hit. Let's see. Oh, nothing's there. He just misses wide left. And Cat Barber kind of looked at the official, and then the whistle was blown. So you see the reaction.
You're just not used to seeing Kent Barber miss that badly.
Well, and when you're an All-American candidate, that sometimes happens for you. When you're a good player, you're not known to miss them like that.
And as you can tell, he guessed the free throw line a bunch, third nationally in made free throws, and he gives the Wolfpack an 11-point lead. Walton posting Barber. Flexion to Gant. Nowhere to take it.
And nothing there for Perrier. Solid inside defense by Lenore Freeman.
Freeman on the floor. They'll get the timeout. Missouri wanted to travel.
You know, Missouri's close to the bucket in the paint. They tried to make a pass. Active hands by Freeman knocked it away. Perrier caught it. Couldn't get it to the rim. And then again, it's a scramble. They lose the basketball.
The crowd wanted that travel. Getting the foul on Barber. Kim Anderson giving an earful to the officials. You just get a sense, if you're a Missouri fan, 14 wins over the last two seasons. If you didn't have 14 wins, there's part of you that believes maybe we wouldn't be getting these calls.
Yeah, you know, there's things about when you're at a home court that can get a crowd going. A, either your team gets you going because of the play, but B, it could be in a call or two. And if the crowd gets involved now because of a call or two, we'll see if the Missouri players respond. The coach has responded. He's not happy. But see if the players pick up the level or emotion and if they're capable of cutting this lead. The tough part about playing a North Carolina State team like this one is that their lead guard has controlled the whole thing from the start of the game, and it's hard to get him off of his even kilter.
Martin. Kicks to his twin brother, Caleb Martin. Off the mark from three, and a loose ball foul NC State. And I think also Missouri sensing this is a critical juncture in the game. 10.5 to play, and team's down by 11. You have the sense that if there's a run to be made, it has to happen soon.
Yeah, you got to find guys out there on the floor that will make a play for them, step up offensively. They can do it defensively, but offensively, who's going to make some buckets? Rosberg will go to the free throw line. Not a comfort zone there, 39%. Kind of started with his struggles at the free throw line a year ago in his junior season, and it's become a confidence factor, which it is for everybody when they go to the foul line that's not in the higher levels of shooting.
Now Missouri 2 of 9 from the free throw line.
Yeah, amazing. Again, when you're in your home building. Coming off a week of finals, they've had practice. Taking a couple days off, get all your classwork done.
Barber draws another foul. Now on the step back, trying to shake Walton.
And I think Barber is the kind of player watching him that understands the frustration of a guy or two that's going to guard him, right? The situation now for Missouri, they're frustrated. They're not scoring on offense. They've missed some free throws. Each of the guys has contributed to maybe a play that's not quite right. That time Walton in his frustration after the shot, not, you know, Cat Barber down. But I think Barber has sensed the feeling of we kind of have control of this game, and how do we keep control of it, especially in the offensive end.
As Barber goes 2 for 2, he is on pace, John, to break a 61-year-old school record for free throw attempts in a season.
Wow. Wow. That says something right there.
The last 20 minutes of the game, it's been a 23-point turnaround. Wolfpack once trailed by 10, now up 13. Rosberg in deep. Hooks it up and over a boot.
Good finish. Mark Gottfried can live with that one. This crowd wants to erupt and get into it. If there could be a defensive stop, but the guy with the ball is not allowing things to happen. It's his pace. It's his control. He draws two. He draws three to him. Kicks it out for a wide open shot by Mark.
Cody Martin for the lead, 13 again. Right, twisting in the lane. Rosberg shucks his man to the ground, and they'll call Rosberg for his fourth foul.
We talked offensively, just the control of the whole game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 white jerseys there. So take your pick. He's either going to finish it himself or find an open teammate. And Cody Martin knocks it in. And when we think of the other side, Terrence Phillips is somewhat of the leader, even though a freshman from Missouri. He's been guarded by one of the Martin twins most of the night. Terrence Phillips 5'11", the Martins are 6'7". So what Mark Gottfried has done is said, we're going to put a big 6'7" athletic guy on Phillips that doesn't allow him to control the offense like he would like to do.
The only upside in that matchup, Terrence Phillips is concerned, is he was teammates with both the Martins at Oak Hill Academy, so at least he knows a bit of the scouting report.
But see, watch the matchup that they can get back. The Phillips more aggressive and went into the body. And that time Martin didn't give space, didn't slide back. But that is such a huge 6'7 and 5'11". The difference is the wingspan that can bother a Phillips as he's looking to run the offense.
It'll be 1-1 for Phillips. And he gets an elusive made free throw for the Tigers. There is that Oak Hill connection. You see Terrence Phillips on the left. One of the Martins on the right.
There's one a group of the
photo.
There
yeah.
They go, yes.
Yeah. Terrence Phillips.
Identical twins.
Very proficient, and you knew the Martins were the recipients of a lot of his passes. His 2 years as the starting point guard at Oak Hill. Oak Hill went 88-4.
That's an amazing record. Again, Oak Hill's done that year in, year out. And players all over the country from Oak Hill splatter these rosters.
Barber almost lost it. See all the attention he attracts, and that leaves Roland open for three.
He almost loses it. He gets it back. It was active hands by Phillips. But Barber tracks it down, and then all eyes are on Barber. And if you're a shooter, if you're Maverick Roland and you're a freshman, just find open spots. Just keep moving and find open spots. Shoot it with confidence because you're playing with a terrific lead guard.
Phillips spots. NC State now enjoying his largest lead.
It's been an impressive second half for the Wolfpack.
NC State picked to finish eighth in the ACC, trying to return to the NCAA tournament for the fifth straight year. They had to close hard last year, John, to get into the tournament. They won five of their last six, and then a buzzer beater to defeat LSU in the first round. And they throttled Villanova in the second round to advance to the Sweet 16 for a second time in four seasons.
Yeah, I wonder Anya that hit the turnaround in the paint against LSU that hung on the rim a little bit, drops in. And it was, it was former Alabama player Trevor Lacey who was so good for that team, and we thought we'd see him again this season, but decided to go in the draft. Wasn't drafted, playing overseas.
Van Leer banged down a couple of threes in that first half, comes in. They might need a few more of those to get within striking range.
Good look at Maverick Rowan, 14 points a ball game, 34 minutes a ball game. A beneficiary of the fact that Terry Henderson is out, that Henderson would be the starter. Rowan coming in as kind of a sharpshooter off the bench. Mark Gottfried said, you know, we got to play him. He's very good. He's very confident as a shooter. We've got to have him shoot. Part of our offensive end.
Clark lines up three. Getting back to Rowan, a very late addition to the roster. He didn't sign with NC State until August because he reclassified in 2015.
And to think when you reclassify and you get in school and all of a sudden you're starting on a team that was a Sweet 16 team and the coaches are saying, we got to have you shoot him. I mean, they need him to play well.
Timeout on the floor. It's been all NC State in the second half. 16-point lead for the Wolfpack. NC State on top, 58-42. Look at that cutie. Never too early to learn the fight song.
Black and gold.
Twitter Tigers down 16. Sunday night on the SEC ESPN Network, we've got two top 20 women's teams squaring off, with number 13 Duke battles number 8 Kentucky, and Michaela Epps, the reigning ESPNW National Player of the Week. Duke versus Kentucky starts at 7 Eastern Sunday on the SEC ESPN Network. It is also streaming live on Watch ESPN. And Kentucky, the rolling opponents, fifth in the nation margin of victory. And Michaela Epps, fifth in the SEC in scoring, had 24 against interstate rival Louisville last week.
A matchup that most of us will turn on to watch.
Duke nearly took down the nation's longest home win streak in South Carolina a couple of weeks ago. Comeback fell just short. Speaking of those streaks, Mark Godfrey could win his 100th game at NC State in his 155th overall game, which would make him the second fastest NC State head coach to reach triple-digit wins, one game ahead of the legendary Jim Valvano.
I said in the first half, all he seems to do is win. Everywhere he's been, every team he's coached, a lot of success.
Barber fouled on the release.
You know, they can't, Missouri cannot get the ball out of Barber's hands. You'd almost, I guess you could say, maybe you try to face guard him and not let him catch, double team him, make him throw it to somebody else. But he's too good, too crafty. He's going to get the ball, then he's going to control, because he's so good off the bounce, he's going to control the pace, going to kind of control where it goes, how it gets there. And if you're, if you're his teammates, and you're playing alongside in this kind of game where you have the lead, now you just spot up and find openings. Because all eyes defensively by Missouri has been on Barber.
In Barber, 31. Career high 37 last month versus Winthrop. Phillips and the stare down with Martin. NC State much more assertive on the glass this second half.
Yeah, they really are. That's a powerful inside team. Not big scores, but just big bodies. And they block shots, they rebound. It might be a limited number of bodies and only seven play. But if you get Henderson back in a few weeks, put him on the offensive end, and the way they play defense and the way Mark Godfrey coached Bobby Lutz, on one of his assistants on that bench, one of the, I think, top collegiate coaching minds that we have, Bobby Lutz. This is a team that will do better than what they're picked in the ACC.
Who charged with his second. Also another former Division I head coach on Mark Gottfried's staff, Orlando Early.
Yeah.
Former head coach of Louisiana Monroe. It's been a quiet night for that man, the freshman Kevin Perrier.
Started his career with 20 points against Wofford opening up, and Kevin's a kid that was highly recruited. I think he's going to be a terrific four-year player along with Terrence Phillips in this SEC conference. I think he's got big upside. He's had some terrific games. He's had some tough games against some bigger type opponents, but that's going to happen. Kim Anderson is calling on a lot of minutes and a lot of production from both Phillips and Perrier. They don't have a lot of help with them, and they'll be frustrating nights. But I think the SEC play for the next 4 years, those two will be pretty valuable.
Perrier grabs a seat. Gant takes his place. Abu, strong take, and he'll pick up another foul.
Size factor, just the girth and the size of a boo versus Gant inside. Just overpowered.
He said they're not particularly deep in the front court, but they've got some earth movers.
Yes. And what they do well is when they attack rebounds. I mean, they go get it versus letting it just kind of bounce around. They go attack it. And I think there's probably an understanding with this team because of the run they made last year, the value of a teammate like Barber, the value of getting Henderson back in a few weeks, the value of the minutes that Maverick Rowan has put in. The Martin twins are very, very good players, different types of players. pass. And Lear for three. Good pass. I think it was Russell Woods and Van Lear. Shooters try to find openings. And if the ball's on one side, you're opposite. If it's in the post, you might be on the wing. If it goes baseline, you slide to the corner. Good move by Van Lear. You can see what his ability is to catch it and release it. His third make of the afternoon.
Well-coached young kid, freshman out of Pacific, Missouri. His dad was his high school head coach. And the strip. Isabel. Made Isabel with the team leading nine.
It has been the bench for Missouri that has been productive. And Barber shook his head because of the turnover, the steal.
Inside again, and Abu gets fouled. Every time NC State needs a bucket there, pounding the post.
Abu averages just under 11 points a game, 7 rebounds a game. Anya at about 6 and 5. Freeman at about 5 and 7. All three just have size and strength and power. That if you don't double team him, or if they have a smaller type body in, they know how to control it and they know how to attack and get to that free throw line.
See how NC State has stretched out this lead after halftime. 2 of 2 trip for a boot.
You know, that's a pretty good looking free throw stroke from a guy shooting 58%.
I'll say. Malik Abu came in averaging a double-double over his last three contests, quietly approaching another one.
Good block by Martin. Wow. See, there's the size. A 6'7", he got back to the shooter. And Isabel is 6 feet tall. It's people don't realize, unless you play the game, where what length can do defensively.
Showing a good mid-range game. Can't find the touch that time. But another offensive rebound for NC State. They have dominated the glass in the second half. Plus 11.
Trying to run some offense. Trying to take shot clock down each possession. And they have just pounded it inside.
Abu with the fadeaway. Rowan with the rebound. And one. Just physically wearing down the Tigers now as Maverick Rowan will have a chance for a three-point play.
And Rowan and Van Lear got locked up. Van Lear at 6'4", and Rowan at 6'7". Really neither guy jumped, but they were locked. And the size advantage and height of Maverick Rowan. Watch two guys and their elbows get locked. It comes just, there's no jumping, but he just ripped it away. Whistle blows, gets it on the rim, drops it in, three-point play.
Makes it a 20-point lead. Cat Barber comes out. Might that be the last we see of Cat Barber? He's had more than his fill tonight, 31 points.
It's a pretty good little trip for Cat Barber, huh? Get on a plane, head to the Midwest. Probably never been to Columbia, Missouri. I'll stop in. Get over 30. Try to get a win. Go back home. Enjoy the Christmas.
And the game-winning buzzer beater from three to beat High Point on Wednesday.
That's a tough shot.
Yeah.
You see it when he bumped in, stepped back? It looked like they were running a play for Maverick Rowan to come off the screen because he'd hit one just previously. Couldn't get it done, but again, Barber understands the game, knocks in the game winner.
He played the full 40 minutes in that game. Certainly deserving of a breather. As that foul charged to NC State, and it takes us to a timeout on the floor. Cat Barber, another 30-point effort. It's an 18-point NC State lead.
Out of here too.
Andy Demetra, John Sunbold, glad you're with us. Andy Demetra, John Sunbold, glad to be with you. From Columbia, Missouri, it was a one-point game at halftime, John, but how has NC State gotten some distance on the Tigers?
Well, you know, I get it. There wasn't much emotion when the Wolfpack showed up. They're tired, they've traveled. And Missouri didn't build a big enough lead, and all of a sudden Cat Barber hits that three, 19 points the first half. They take the lead. The second half, defensively, this Wolfpack team has been better. They've only allowed one attempt. They've challenged shots, and when they've got rebound, they've pushed. And then what Cat Barber did in the second half was control the tempo and made plays for his teammates, and then the teammates responded. They pounded inside. They made plays. He's opened it up. He's drawn double teams, triple teams. And when he has, he's made the pass. His teammates have connected. They've played a much better second half.
It shows you the value of having a veteran like Cat Barber, something that Missouri doesn't have. And SEC play is coming up fast. Missouri, of course, we know what happened last year, 3-15 in the SEC. From what you've seen of the Tigers so far, where do they need to make the most improvements as we get set for SEC play for them to maybe exceed some expectations?
Well, what has to always happen, coaches coach and players play, and players, there is a player or two that must step up and kind of have an out-of-body transformation. You're no longer a freshman when you get to conference play, even though there'll be some tough nights. You must develop a confidence about your game that can travel and no matter what not be frustrated by a mistake. So if Terrence Phillips, which I think can be a good lead guard, take control and make your plays. Good or bad, make your plays. Kevin Purrier, make your plays, be aggressive, be as tough and aggressive as you can and not worry about some of the misplays. If you don't do that, then you kind of struggle because you wonder about mistakes and things like that. Nice pass.
Underneath, Abu hangs and finishes.
Almost a perfect possession by North Carolina State.
13-11 for the sophomore, Abdul Malik Abu. Mark no good from three. And a foul under the basket on NC State. Also, rebounding going to be an issue for this Tigers team. They just don't possess a lot of size.
Yeah, they're not thick enough. I mean, you might have enough, you know, 6'7", 6'8", but not thick enough. And when you know, look at North Carolina State, the bodies, the size, the power. Not every SEC school is big, but most of them, they're big bodies, right? Night in, night out, you get to conference play in a Power 5, you're going to be challenged around the rim. And that's going to be an issue for this Missouri squad.
Just the beginning stages of the rebuild under the native son, Kim Anderson, second year back at his alma mater.
And they're 5-0 at home. This will be their first loss. One of his first things he said this season was they got to protect home turf, play better at home than they did a year ago. And even when you get conference play, they beat LSU here a year ago. They beat Florida here a year ago. Things like that.
Slips it to Martin. All belong to Missouri. Well, not a lot of time for this Tigers team to sulk, though, John, because Kim Anderson's team next Wednesday in St. Louis for the bragging rights game against Illinois.
Yeah, one of the great events. The arena will be half full of the Illini fans and half full of Missouri fans. Been going on forever. Good challenge from the SEC and the Big Ten, two teams that get together and really gives a barometer for programs and coaches to see where their team is. They've had some great games over the years.
Triple by West Clark makes it a 16-point game. Illinois also a team that's been very erratic this season.
Yeah, and been injured. They had injuries. They went overseas this summer, had a couple injuries over there to guards that they will rely upon. I think that's the toughest part for coaches nowadays of anything is when you rely on a guy, whether they go pro early or you get through summer and all of a sudden you have an injury to a main player that changes the course of your team if you're not deep enough.
NC State will win six of its last seven games. What do you think? Tournament team for the fifth straight year? What do you think NC State still needs to prove to
reach
the dance
again? Well, I think they can. You know, it comes down to conference play. How well do you play? How many wins can you get? Their non-conference, you know, you lose right off the bat to William & Mary. You didn't play well. You lose to Arizona State, although that was a good game up in Brooklyn. You do beat LSU. You lose to Michigan. Beat South Florida. You know, it's a team that I think continually will get better. because when they get healthier. But I do think it can be a tournament team, but the conference play will decide it. The non-conference probably wasn't good enough. The losses won't help them when you start doing resume. So what they have to do will take care when they get to conference play, win some huge home games. The best part about being in great leagues, Andy, is the fact that you get to beat great teams. You know, you get to play Duke, and you get to play North Carolina and Virginia and Maryland. You get to play them all, right? And so you have a chance to have a terrific resume.
You got resume builders on your schedule each week. So Missouri unable to do what you, John Sumvol, did your career at Missouri, which was beat NC State.
Yeah, back 1983, Thurl Bailey, that national championship team that year. Derek Wittenberg, who I got to talk to tonight, assistant athletic director. Sidney Lowe. That team came in, Jim Valvano, in the old building, the Hearn Center, right across the street. We knocked them off, I think it was a January game. They went on and made quite a run and won the tournament. And they've always said Derek Wittenberg had the best air ball in the history of college basketball, huh? Great player.
Well, you got to be known for something. And Thurl Bailey, you guys were 7 picks apart in the first round of that draft.
Thurl, a good guy, played a long time in the NBA. Really good guys on that team. And back in the day when juniors and seniors kind of stayed around forever, you got to know guys. You played, you know, each other in different venues and events. And got to know each other a little differently than the college game is now. A lot of one and done guys.
Another foul inside. You saw Barber take a seat a moment ago from Kent Barber. 33 points. Sweet outline. Third in the nation in made free throws. Just another 13 of 15 night at the office at the free throw line.
Well, it's a broken record. We keep saying the value of having a lead guy out there that runs the show and can control the show and defensively makes it so difficult to get him not to run the show. How do you do it? The only way you can do it is keep the ball out of his hands, and Missouri didn't do that. And Barber was the story. That first half, he kept his team in it. Second half, the teammates showed up, and it was a pretty impressive 20 minutes from this Wolfpack team.
Tigers will fall to 5-5. NC State improves to 8-3. 1 point Wolfpack lead at halftime. They put the clamps on the Tigers in the second half. And NC State head coach Mark Gottfried earns his 100th win as the boss of the Wolfpack does it 155 games, one game fewer than the great Jim Valvano.
Well, a former coach from the SEC likes to beat some SEC teams. So a good win for his squad. You fly halfway across the country, you don't know how your guys will respond. I thought the second half, the 20 minutes, were terrific by this ball club. It'll make everything easier for them as they get on the plane and head back home.
First home loss suffered by Kim Anderson's Tigers this year as they continue to search for a win over a power conference opponent in the non-conference schedule. Tigers again fall to 5-5, but the big bragging rights game looming next week in St. Louis against the University of Illinois. Kent Barber, a name we called out often tonight, 19 points in the first half. He finishes with 33, and pacing NC State to a final win tonight of 73-59 over Missouri. We'll be back to wrap up our game. We'll send you in a moment to Peter Burns and the gang inside the studio. Once again, 73-59, NC State takes it tonight in Columbia.
All right, thank you, gentlemen. We're about 10 minutes away from that one. We'll get you all the way caught up until that game starts. Peter Burns, Glenn Big Baby Davis, and Damian Fishback. Gentlemen, when we saw North Carolina State and Mizzou at half, NC State finally got that one last shot to go ahead and take the lead. What happened, though, in the second half?
I think you got to give a lot of credit to Coach Mark Gottfried and Kent Barber. Let's remember, even at Alabama, Coach Mark Gottfried went to 8 out of 10 postseasons, 5 NCAA tournaments when he was there. He's getting the same thing done. This is a Missouri team that's extremely young and still trying to find their identity, Glenn.
I really think the energy changed from the first half. You see Mizzou playing, you know, to NC State. They're bringing it to them, and then next thing you know, NC State going into the second half, say, hey, we're not going to take this anymore. And, you know, they did a good job second half.
You're talking about Young. 48% of the scoring from Missouri Tigers right now come from one of those four freshmen, which is incredible. So let's talk about the learning process for Kim Anderson's squad right now. Is that what we're seeing right now? Is Kim Anderson having a bunch of young bucks out there saying, hey, go out there and learn, because this is not just this year. It's for the next couple of years in Columbia.
Yeah, he's trying to build a program. You know, it's difficult. You've got a young team and a coach that's in his second year. And so that's why you see Missouri get out rebounded in 20 second chance points by a team like NC State. That's why you see it being challenging for them to guard a guy who they know coming into the game is an outstanding player in Cat Barber, but just weren't able to contain him.
Out rebounded 41-29 for the Missouri Tigers. So we're going to go back down to Columbia. Andrew Demetra and John Sunvol, let's give it a little bow on what happened down at Mizzou Arena.
Missouri, they led by as many as 10 in the first half, but I think when Cat Barber raised up, made that three at the horn to give NC State its first lead going into halftime, that kind of swung the game for good.
Yeah, I think what you try to do on the road, if you don't have something going, and the home team, Missouri, 10-point lead, crowd was pretty vocal. Missouri didn't stretch it, though. They didn't keep it going. They weren't good defensively enough that they could stretch something and North Carolina State not be in it. And Cat Barber simply kept his team there. Nobody was really playing with him, right, the first half. He has 19 to the 29. Kept everything in context, the fact that he didn't force a shot. But he kept his guys there. And then Mark Gottfried obviously gave him a speech at halftime, said, we now have 20 minutes, right? We're done. We don't have foul problems. We have 20 minutes. We better defend. We better rebound. And then we're going to push the ball. And then really, Barber, once they got six or eight ahead, Missouri couldn't keep it out of his hands. And he controlled the whole tempo. It was his game, controlled it. Missouri had no answers.
Missouri's top two scorers are freshmen, and per year, Dan Phillips. And every now and again, you're going to be reminded that they're still freshmen. So it's up to some other guys to try to step up and fill that scoring void. Tigers got it today from sophomore Tremaine Isabel, in particular in the first half.
Yeah, I thought Isabel came off, well, really the bench, 23 points out of the 28 first half. Isabel came off, had seven in the first half, had three more in the second. He was aggressive and made some really terrific plays early, and that gave this team energy, but they couldn't sustain it with enough bodies. And if we go back and think, on our opening, all we talked about was Cat Barber. And sometimes you worry about all the opening, say, well, hope we don't jinx the guy. He was so dominant that at times it didn't look like he worked up a sweat, right? He just did it with ease. He did it with class. He kept the ball in his hands. He got it to his teammates. It was fun to watch.
So shifty off the dribble. Again, Cat Barber, 33 points, 9 of 15 from the floor, and 13 of 15 from the free throw line. Even though Missouri shot a higher percentage from the floor, the Tigers fall 73-59 to NC State. We'll send it back to Peter Burns and the gang inside the studio.